What's up, bros? 600 subs. I don't think I mentioned it in the video, but I must have mentioned it in the description. This video is being made because of the 600 subscribers. I am so happy. I finally have 600 subs, yo. I have to be extremely honest. I haven't worked really hard in the last 1 week or the last 1 week to two weeks or something with respect to the YouTube. I haven't really put up many videos or anything, but I think you guys know that. I'm really busy with playing with South Park, and I'm really enjoying South Park, Bioshock Infinite. I just downloaded and just bought FIFA 14 on the PC and on Origin and stuff, and I'm enjoying that. It's something I used to do back in college. We used to play a lot of FIFA on the PC. So anyways, that's what I'm doing right now, which is why we don't have a lot of the Last of Us footage up. I don't know what video I'm going to be uploading right now. The video that I have in mind is, well, you know what, I think I might keep that as a separate video in itself. I'll just keep some Last of Us video in the background. Alright, so this video is something different. It's something that I had planned when I saw that, you know, I might be hitting 600 in a few weeks. I thought of it maybe at around 550, 560 or something. That when I reach 600 subs, I think I might do something special. I might do something exceptional, and I'll keep doing it. I'm not going to do it, you know, for just randomly or at the drop of a hat or anything else. You know, just completely randomly. I might do it at every 100 subs or something like that, like a milestone. Every 100 subs or something is something that I thought of right now. I don't know how I'll be doing it. So what I'm going to be doing is sharing a couple of personal stories or a few background stories about myself, or basically who or what Newuxtreme is in real life, in the sense that, you know, there's a lot more to Newuxtreme than you just see headshots and four nations and, you know, trash talking and the stupid Indian accent and everything. There's a lot big, a lot of a background to who and what Newuxtreme is. I'm not going to be giving out any kind of personal details, not about myself, because I honestly don't care about myself. I mean, it's fine. A lot of people do know who I am personally, and there really isn't too much harmful that anybody can really do about it. And most of the harmful stuff is racism, and that's already taken place. So there's really nothing worse that can happen. But what I mean by this is, if I'm going to be sharing stories about my personal history, my past, and my background, I'm going to keep everyone else who is in the story, since this person is a real person and, you know, all the incidents and everything is are real. I'm not going to mention anyone's name just to maintain their privacy and stuff. So anyways, let's move on. There's not going to be any length for this video. I haven't decided how long this video is going to be. I'm just going to keep on going and keep on rambling on, because I haven't really put down a script or anything of how I'm going to be going with this. So I hope you guys do not get bored when I do start off with the story time. I hope you guys enjoyed. And let's keep moving. Alright, okay, well, one thing before you even start off, so I'm so sorry. 600 subs, thank you everyone for sharing the video. Thank you everyone for getting your friends who might never have seen any videos and getting, you know, sharing it with them, sharing them on networks like Facebook or anything else. It's because of these things that, you know, we've grown, the channel has grown that fast. So I ask you to please, I request you to please keep doing it, but do not do it with this video, because I do not want, like, this is kind of a personal insight or background kind of a thing that I would really prefer that, you know, the subs that I've had forever, you know, for them to know about me. Not this isn't something that I want to do in order to get more subs or anything. I mean, this is the last thing I would want in order to, you know, for the growth of my channel or something. It's just, I know so many of you guys, and I do know of some of you guys personally now, like Mackers, Pino. I have other friends that you guys might not know, that I know from Uncharted and stuff. So, you know, just sharing, since I know so much stuff about you guys might not know as much about me. So I thought, you know what, let's just try something and share a little bit with someone else. And maybe someone else who has a similar kind of a story or something, you know, so we get to learn from each other's experiences. So obviously you've already read the title that's on top. It might be saying something like how I pissed off a Supreme Commander General naval officer, and it's the absolute truth. This guy, let me give you guys a background on how this happened. Those of you who know me from, you know, on my real Facebook and stuff, which is something that I actually never use, to be honest. I never really use my real Facebook except to keep up on certain trends or news or something, because I personally find Facebook to be like a huge waste of time, except for, like, it's a huge waste of time in terms of socializing. I find it to be extremely useful with respect to marketing and networking and finding people and stuff like that. So that's, you know, everything has its pros and cons, and that's how I use Facebook. I do not use Facebook at all in terms of socializing, so there's no point in following me on my real Facebook. If anything, you guys could probably follow me on my gaming Facebook, which is where I do everything that you guys are interested in, which is uploading videos, having subscriber lobbies, or just letting people know that I'm online right now, and we might have a spot here or there in the party, and somebody can join in. So anyways, people who know my real and actual Facebook, they have seen in the work status thing that it mentions I had a short stint, or I think it still mentions that I'm still working with the Indian Army, and that's not true. I'm definitely not working with the Indian Army right now, but yeah, I did have a short stint, and this is of course related to the exact same thing. See, when I was in my final year of engineering, something that I feel is quite important is that a person should develop in every single aspect or field that there is. A lot of people might think that video games are a waste of time and stuff. I don't think so at all. I think it helps a lot with your CNS. I think it helps a lot with your hand-eye coordination. I think it helps a lot with decision making and making quicker decisions, and even, you know, what decisions you want to make. And like people say, for a lot of team sports, which is like, I played football for 9 years. I played football at a competitive level for say 2 to 3 to 4 years or something, but I played football for about 8 to 9 years, and people say that, you know, leadership comes from sports, and of course it does. But at the same time, like, if you've seen some of the videos from the video games, the competitive games that we have from Four Nations and stuff, it's the exact same thing. Either the footballing leadership has come here, or the same leadership, whatever, that has been built in me seems to kind of come out with respect to, you know, telling people to do this or do that and guiding someone. And, you know, what happens when a team, whether it's a football team or it's a video game team, you know, how to build up morale and come back and blah, 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 blah. So, yeah, I find video games to be extremely important. I find weightlifting, you know, all different kinds of things. So by the time I'd finished school, actually, my mom was huge into studying. So I finished getting excellent grades and stuff way back in school. Like, I scored 100%, 50 out of 50, 100 out of 100, you know, excellent scores, ace, number one student. I got rank one when I was really young, like class 1, 2, 3 or something. I don't even remember how, but it was rank one, year after year. And, you know, I did that part, and then I got bored of it. I thought, you know, that there's a lot more to life than just studying. And at that time, my mom wouldn't agree, of course, because which mom doesn't want, you know, their son to come as rank one, especially if they are able to come as rank one. But that's going kind of off topic. So I'd already done the studying bit. So by the time I came to college, I had other stuff to worry about. Like, I found that socializing, meeting people, creating a network, you know, finding out and not getting caught up in negative things, for example, drinking or smoking or poker and stuff like that. That just happens every single place in every single university around the world. So, you know, not getting caught up in that stuff and still being on a developmental path and stuff. But I wasn't into the studying as much. So by the time we came into the fourth and final year of engineering, I didn't have such good grades. In fact, I had pretty bad grades. I flunked a lot of subjects, but I never repeated a year or anything, which is actually a huge deal, because this is kind of a story for another time. But, you know, I just did pretty bad. All right, let me just say that throughout engineering, I was always on the brink of doing really bad. Let's just say that I would always just save myself, you know, something like that. So by the time the final year came by and everybody was looking for a job or, you know, getting placed in different places, that's something that happens in India at least. I don't know about you guys that are abroad, but we look for placements and stuff. So when I got into the fourth year, I, like everyone else, we were looking for jobs, and I did get placed in a different company afterwards, but we had the Indian Army thing coming in before that. So we got, I got placed in a company by the name of TCS, which is an extension of HP. Everybody knows Hewlett Packard, your HP printers and laptops and stuff like that. So I got placed in HP's service-based company. Sorry, that's not TCS, I'm so sorry. That's Emphasis. I forgot the fucking name. It's been so long. But anyways, we're back to the Army thing. We had this, and I'm sure this happens in a lot of different schools as well, and not just universities or colleges and stuff. You know, Army. If you're interested in the Army, there are a lot of pickups that happen all the way from the school level up till university, or maybe even post-grad after that. There are a lot of doctors in the Army, there are engineers in the Army. I finished my engineering, of course, so they came for engineering recruitment. And there are a lot of ways to get in. So this person, this Supreme Commander Indian, oh my God, I don't even remember all of the things he'd done. He was retired, of course. He wasn't like in the Army at the time. He had retired, which is why he had the time to come for all these lectures and seminar kind of things, and just telling other people about the pros and cons of having an Army life. And of course, when they're selling their product, like even the Army is kind of selling its product, as in saying that we are the best. So of course, they won't really tell you all of the cons, but they will tell you all of the pros and stuff. And this is not a complaint or anything. I'm just telling you what all was happening. But this guy, and all of these guys also, they have these badges or these medals and stuff on the left side of, basically on their shoulders. I'm sure you guys have seen this in the movies. They have these different medals and badges and stuff for every either mission they complete or every rank they go up and stuff like that. This guy's jacket was fucking filled. He's a pretty old guy, like probably 65 plus, 70 plus or something. And he had a huge, hugely successful career in the Navy. And so, you know, we were quite inspired. Yeah, of course, yes, we were a little bit desperate in the sense that we didn't really have a job until then. But I was always kind of infatuated with the Army, even back in school. I mean, after that, I saw different things. I read different things. I don't know if you guys have ever heard of Zeitgeist, but I saw that. And then I did a little bit of research according to that. And I wasn't really into getting into the Army and stuff, but I'll tell you why I still gave the exams and the interviews and everything, and I still passed, and why I even have that working stint. The thing is, in India, we have this exam, we have this university called IIT, and every single Indian knows what it is, and every single Indian kind of hates hearing those words, the IIT. It stands for the Indian Institute of Technology, but everybody in India basically wants to get into the IIT because that just means it's something like a safe or smooth sailing for the rest of your life, something like that. That's how it is marketed, that if you get into the IIT, you will be having all kinds of companies picking you up, and there will be incredible salaries and blah, 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 and all that kind of stuff. So everyone's parents and everyone, whoever wants to do it themselves, are studying for the IIT since you know, they're really young and in school. So this exam that I had to give for the for getting through the Army, it was called the SSB, or it was called the State Selection Board, and this thing was supposed to be the equivalent of the IIT in terms of self-development and personal development, and you know, and IQ and a mix of every single thing, which is why this, and I told you guys that I'm huge into self-development and personal development, so which is why I was so excited to be able to give this exam, just to see how and where I stand. You know, there are some times that you just want to test yourself. You don't really want to get in, but a certain exam tells you where you're going to be. Like, for example, an IQ exam gives you an idea of how you are doing compared to the other average, or compared to other people who are giving the exam and stuff like that. So you just want to give the exam. You don't really want to get in somewhere, which is why I wanted to give this exam. So when when this guy came over, we were really excited, and I really wanted to go and give this exam. And for that, I wanted to get like this is something that I still do till this day, and I found it to be extremely helpful. Whatever you want to do in life, just make sure that you make the effort to find out a little bit before you take any first step. And this might sound so simple, but people just don't do it. It can be as simple as buying a laptop or an iPod or a phone or something or whatever, a watch, or I don't even care what it is, but or selecting a weight training program or something. But the thing is, people just do it. People just they put stuff off for so long and until the end, and then they say, you know what, I don't care what I'm doing, I'm just doing it, because they put themselves in that situation. So before you do it, just make sure that you're not wasting your time and find out what it is that you want to do, and just try and find out a little bit about the thing, research a little bit about the thing. It'll help you so much. So for my research, who would be the best person to tell me how to prepare for the exam for the SSB, which is supposed to be, by the way, like I told you, it's like they test your IQ, they test your, oh my God, there were so many different things. I don't even remember. This is like 3 or 4 years ago. They test situational awareness, like legit situational, actual situational awareness in real life. Like, how would you do it? Like, I'll just give you an example. They say that you and your friends of 6 or 7 people are, you're supposed to attend a friend's marriage at point A, which is say 10, 5 kilometers away or something. And there's only a bus going to it at this time. At point B, there's an armed robbery going on at this place where there are 4 people or 5 people over there. Only a train takes you over there every half an hour or something. And at point C, either a fire is broken out or there are some wild animals attacking next to a school or something. And the only way to get there is by some other, mode of conveyance that might go only every half an hour. Or maybe you can just walk and or run towards it, and it'll take you like 15 minutes running in order to get to the school or something. The point is, it'll give you different situations, and now and then they'll tell you, okay, start, and you have to, one person in your team has to decide about allotting their resources and doing what they're going to do, how they're going to do, how they're going to break up, split up in order to solve the problem to the best, best of their abilities or best of their capabilities and stuff. And this was just one thing. I don't even remember what they used to call this, but I'm just trying to give you an example that this is an example of the situational awareness exam that they had. Of course, they had the IQ. Of course, they had, I wouldn't say it was and analytical skills. I think it was more like, what do you see in a picture? Like, they would put a picture in front of the entire everyone giving the exam, and they would say, write down everything, or oh yeah, I now I remember. They would say, write down every single thing that you see on screen. And these pictures are really bad. Like, they were black and white, and they were like handmade, so they were really bad. You couldn't tell one thing from the other. It was just, what do you see? That's the psychologist who is trying to analyze. He just wants to see basically what is it that you see in the picture. Number one, write everything down, whatever you see. And number two, create a story of everything that you see in that picture. Just create a storyline of what you see. And again, the psychologist would try and analyze the story and find out something about your psyche, so you can understand how amazing this exam was. When I found out that these are the kind of things that they ask you. I think there was one other. Of course, they have group discussions and GD and stuff like that. That's like kid stuff compared to the stuff that they were asking. They had physical evaluations, physical health, etc. evaluations, which is a fucking joke, because I think I mentioned that. I started weight training and stuff when I was in my 2nd year, so this is around the 4th year or 5th year, 4th year in my college stuff. So I was like, I had no problem at all with the physical evaluation. What else was it? A lot of interesting stuff. So I wanted to give this exam. I definitely wanted to give. Okay. Oh, sorry. I just remembered, and I think you guys are gonna enjoy this. But every single, like this exam, all of these exams were covered over a group, over like a period of time, period of 3 to 7 days, depending on how you were doing. You'd be kicked out on the first day, the second day, third day, whatever it is. They also had some really, really, really simple logical stuff and English and stuff, which was so easy. I can't even, it was a fucking joke. It was that easy. But basically, at the end of these 7 days, you are being evaluated throughout these 7 days, and then at the end of the 7th day, there will be it was something like there will be two evaluators. One would be a person. How do I put this? Like, there were two evaluations. I don't remember if it was two people who would evaluate you, or there were two evaluations. One is the results that you get from every single paper that you see. All right, so that is one result. And then after the 7 days, you have to go and meet this psychologist / counselor / whatever analyst person, and then you would have a conversation with him about all different kind of things. And then he would create a profile with you, and then he would have your results for the past 7 days, and they would match these two results and then see whether this person actually matches up the same way in his current profiling as he has in the past 7 days, or whether this, you know, whether there is I think the best way to explain it would be like, is there a split personality, or, you know, if they don't match up, like, is this trying to fake something and stuff like that. Like, this is something that we heard, like, do not fake anything. Be truthful about everything, and that's it. I mean, people are not going to not select you or not take you because you're truthful, but if they find that you're trying to fake something, that's like an instant, kick out. You'll be kicked out. So, yeah, this was, like, it was intimidating, but at the same time, it was so exciting and so interesting. I just wanted to see my results and how they were. So, I was like, you know, who's the best person to tell me about this kind of stuff? And, of course, that Supreme Commander, Navy General, blah, 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 blah. I don't know. I don't even remember all of the different titles that he was given. But, of course, it's that guy. So, I was like, as soon as the seminar stuff ended, I ran up to him and said that, sir, I would love it if I could ask you a few questions, or if you could give me some tips and some guidelines as to how I should be preparing for the same. And he was very happy to hear that. And he just said that, you know what, find out from everyone around you, whoever's in the seminar, whoever's interested, and then you can call me and set up a time, and then we can meet up, and I'll give all of you guys like a personal debriefing and, you know, something like that, as opposed to just one by one, if people are coming to him one by one. So I was like, excellent, that's fine. So I took his number, I took his card. Now, this is where the best part actually happens. I had friends who were really good guys, really fun guys, everything else, but only one of them really wanted to get into the army, and I think that was because his father was in the army, or a relative was in the army, or something like that. But everybody else was like, there wasn't anyone else like me that wanted to give the exam because they were interested in the exam and how awesome the exam was. But they were just like, you know what, we don't have anything else to do, why not just give this exam, something like that. Everybody else was like that. So it was really hard finding out who wanted to actually go for the consultation, for the debriefing and stuff, and who didn't. So I had one friend, my main friend, who of course wanted to go, and me and him, and I guess three, four, the third guy who I said that who really did want to get into the army because of his father and his family and stuff. So I got the number of all of these guys, and I called Mr. So-and-so, and I said, sir, it's 4, 5, 6 of us. You tell us where you want to meet up. Do you want to meet up at the same place that you took the last seminar? My apartment, myself, I used to live in an apartment. I left the hostels and stuff towards the second, third year, and I moved out into my own apartment, which is like a fantastic decision. Off topic, I just suggest everyone to try and live by yourself. It's amazing. Anyways, so I said, then, you know what, sir, I have my own place, and if you want, I can invite everyone over here, and you can visit us over here, and, you know, it won't be any issues. So he said, you know what, come to my place, which was maybe like 5 kilometers away, and I had a bike back then, and everybody else had conveyance as well. So we were like, yeah, sure, we can do that. So he said, let's do it Sunday at 7. Let's do it Sunday at 7 o'clock. I was like, yes, sir, definitely Sunday at 7 o'clock. First of all, I was like, Sunday at 7 o'clock, but then again, this man is a fucking Indian commander, Supreme Naval, blah, 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 like I mentioned. This guy, so I was like, you know, I'm sure he's busy every single other time, so there's no point in arguing with him, because the only reason I'm saying is because, let's face it, which fucking college student wants to wake up on Sunday and or wants to work on Sunday? So no one. And the best part is everybody gets high and gets fucked on Friday and Saturday. So how is anybody, and they don't wake up until like 4, 5, 6, 7 p.m. in the evening. And I was like, okay, you know what, let's just do Sunday, and anyone who is serious will be going there. So he's like, okay, he had some three other people who were interested that he knew. So he said that these three people will be coming by themselves. You and your group of 6, 7 other friends, please join us at 7 o'clock on Sunday. So I was like, yes, sir, definitely. And I had excellent terms. Of course, the man was extremely respectable, of course. I mean, dude, he's qualified. That guy was amazing. Like, his charisma and stuff was fantastic. So Saturday, Friday, we're having fun. Saturday, we're having fun, and me and my friends are just chilling out. Like I mentioned before, I didn't drink or smoke or anything, so I wasn't high or anything, but... You know, Saturday, Sunday, we just have fun. Friday, Saturday, we just had fun. I don't know, must have gone clubbing or done something. And Sunday, in the middle of the motherfucking night, somebody is calling me. And I pick up the fucking phone. I was like, who is this? Who the fuck is this? Because everybody's sleeping. And I was like, who the fuck is this? He's like, this is Supreme Commander, blah, 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 blah. Am I speaking to Mr. This? I was like... I fucking fell out of my bed. I woke up with a shock. I almost fell out of my bed. And I was like, oh, yes, sir, yes, sir. Yes, sir, how are you? And I'm so sorry. I was sleeping. And he's like, are you saying that you're back home? I was like, yes, sir, I am back home. And I'm checking the watch. And for me, it's the middle of the motherfucking night because I slept at, I don't know, 3, 4, 5 a.m. So I was like, yes, sir, I'm asleep. I'm back home. And I just mentioned, you know, yes, sir, I'm going to be coming at 7 o'clock. So he's like, it's 7:05 right now. Where are you? I'm like, 7:05? But, sir, we're supposed to meet at 7 p.m., right? So he's like, no, why would we meet at 7 p.m.? I said 7 o'clock. And, and I was shocked. At first of all, I wasn't scared or anything. I was just shocked. I was like, is this guy seriously calling like 7 or 8 final year students who are not working, who are not studying? In the final year, we don't even need to study. We just have a project that doesn't really take too much time. We don't really have to work too much on it. I was like, is this guy seriously calling 7 jobless students who on a fucking weekend at 7 a.m. in the morning, at 7 a.m. in the morning on a Sunday? And he was like, you know what, my three people are already here. I didn't expect this from you, and best of luck to you, and that's it. And I think he cut off his phone, and that was it. So I was shocked for, like, I swear to God, I was shocked for, like, the first 5, 10, 15 seconds or something. And then I was all by myself. And then I burst out laughing, because I was like... Dude, really? 7 a.m. in the morning on a Sunday? You want people, the college students to come to you at fucking 7 a.m. in the morning? And just so you guys know, this is a fucking place in India where there are like 23 or 24 universities in like 2 or 3 fucking square kilometers. 23 fucking universities in 2 or 3 fucking square kilometers. And if you have so many universities or colleges or whatever, of course people are going to be doing drugs and drinking and this and that, and everybody knows that people are going to be doing all of that stuff. And when else will people be doing it except for on a Friday or a Saturday? So of course everyone was fucking knocked out, and I couldn't even tell anyone else. So I tried calling my first friend and saying that, you dude, this guy actually wanted to meet us at 7 a.m. in the fucking morning. And I wasn't able to catch him because nobody was up. Nobody was up at 7 a.m. So I just fell back asleep. And then later on, when I woke up, let's say 4, 5, 6 p.m., I picked up the phone and I called him, and I said, dude, the guy actually called us at 7 a.m. in the morning. And even he was shocked. He's like, really? He called us at 7 a.m. in the morning? And this is why the entire thing was so confusing, because when you're in the fucking army, you have the military time. You have 0 to 2400 hours. That's what they say. They say 1630 hours, 1730 hours. He didn't say 0700 hours at all, because, like, I know that. He didn't say 0700 or 7 a.m. or 7 in the morning. He didn't mention anything. He just said 7 o'clock, 7 o'clock, 7 o'clock, and that was it. And I'm so sure that we must even have spoken about something in the evening, which is why everyone was so sure about 7 p.m. So, I mean, that was one of the funniest things that I'd ever done. And I was, I mean, I wasn't scared because the man was really, of course, he was respectable. I mean, you just felt bad disappointing a person like that. That was the worst part. But at the end of the day, it was funny as fuck. It was fucking funny as fuck when you're trying to call. You're trying to call spoked up, doped out, high on fucking alcohol students in their final year of basically enjoying their university and college life at 7 a.m. in the fucking morning. That was one of the funniest things ever. So yeah, that was my. Of course, then I did do everything else by myself. I studied by myself. I found out what to do, what not to do, etc., etc. I did go there and I cleared the exams and everything, which is why my Facebook reads when I joined them. But this is how I, yeah, this is basically how I did piss off a Supreme Commander, Navy General. I don't even know what all the stuff he had on his card. It was just Admiral. I don't even fucking remember all that kind of stuff. So yeah, let me know what you guys think about this. Like I said, there's no time limit on this video. I have no clue how long this is. It was fun, man. It was really fun, and I hope you guys enjoyed this as well. I already have an idea of what I want to talk about in my 700 subscriber videos. I have another plan for what I want to do for the 600 subs. I might be putting it out in another video. I don't want to make this one any longer than it already is. So yeah, let me know if you guys have ever had. I know that some of the people, some of the subscribers and stuff are in the army. I mean, were in the army or have done a short stint in the army. Like, I don't know if they wouldn't mind me calling them out, but one of the friends that we've all seen, Motik, we all know about him. I think maybe Dale has from Australia is in the army or something. So if you guys have any interesting stories, not just these guys, not just the guys who are or were in the army or something. I'm just saying, just, you know, if you guys have any such funny stories, something similar to this, please do share it in the comment section below. And yeah, I guess I'll see you next time. See you guys.